chin. Oh, look at that tail. She's so cute. Oh, look. She's wagging to herself. Come on, Blue. Oh, she woke up on the right side of the bed. Hello, everybody. Happy Wednesday. I look as bad as I feel. Is that the saying? I don't actually know if that's the right way around. My brain is just not functioning. Hello. You came to join Mum's bath time in the morning. Here's little Baz. He's 6 months old now. Me and I worked out last night. He's 6 months and 4 days. And here's Bluebee. She's having a very good morning. They've been playing. I'm actually just about to run myself a morning bath, which I know is very bougie and I never do this, but my body is just like, I'm literally like this at the moment because I had a shoot day yesterday. I had a shoot day a few days before and it involved a lot of muscle work and every single muscle in my body I can feel is just like, come on, hun, we're done for the week, give us a rest. So I'm gonna run myself a really nice bath. I'm just gonna have a bit of a self-care day because I have had a very few busy days shooting bits and bobs and being in London, which sounds weird because we are in lockdown, but it was all allowed, I promise. So I'm gonna run myself a nice bath. Also, sorry there wasn't a second video. Actually, hang on, I'm gonna see if, I hope I'm not too loud if I run the bath while I have a chat with you. Will it be too loud? I don't know. Let's have a look. Is that too loud? No, it's actually not too bad, is it? Is that loud, Baz?
Hello.
So I might get a Christmas bath bomb. I'm gonna get a bit festive with you today as well because I feel like we're really edging towards December. I have one more vlog before Vlogmas. How quick does that turn around? And I'm gonna take you in here to have a chat. Anyway. Sorry that there wasn't a second video. It's just a really busy time. I'm trying to get everything I can done before Vlogmas so then I can like fully commit to vlogging and stuff often. Oh, look at these two besties. Oh, I love them so much. Aren't they just the cutest little two? And Pop. I don't know where Pop is right now, but I'm just so obsessed. These two make life so much better. I've been longing for this Christmas, when everyone's around to share this holiday. Yes, it's a time of happiness, a time of joy, but now this year is twice as special because I'm hoping for. Right, I'm only going to talk about this once, and if you're not from the UK, this is going to be like, what are you on about? But who has watched the John Lewis Christmas advert this year? I am, do you know what? I was on the train yesterday. Anyone just sit on the train sometimes or the car and look out the window and play music and just feel like you're in a film? I was doing that yesterday on the train to the song from the Christmas advert, the John Lewis Christmas advert. I'm so obsessed with this song and just the advert is the cutest thing. I'm just gonna play a tiny bit because I will get copyrighted. But if you haven't watched this, hang on, let me just go to the song part. I choose a kindness and if you gave some to me. Oh, I love it so much. It's just so cute. And the McDonald's one, do you know what? I watched these adverts, I think they came out like a few days ago and I was on YouTube and I was watching through the McDonald's one, the John Lewis one, and what was the other one that was good? The Disney one. I was crying. I was like, I showed him it after I cried and watched it and he was like, I don't get it. The Disney one's so cute though, it reminds me of my grandma because it's about a grandma, it's just so cute. But yeah, anyway, if you haven't watched them, please watch them. And the John Lewis one, anyway, I just wanted to share that because if you haven't actually had a look, and that's something that I love at the moment when I'm watching telly, I actually don't mind watching the adverts because it's usually the Christmas adverts. It's just my favorite time of year, this time of year. Anyway, I'm actually gonna put on something, not The Crown. I haven't watched The Crown. Has anyone watched The Crown? I'm watching so many good things at the moment. Recently started watching The Undoing and it's amazing. Do you know what? They need to make a Christmas specific section because
Has anyone else been trying to find that? I'm probably gonna watch The Grinch, let's be honest. Anyway, my bath seems to have overfilled itself today too, and it's gone green. I had a blue bath bomb, and it's not looking too appetizing, but my bath does usually, my bath is like a weird bath that's electronic, where it fills itself up to a point automatically, so you don't have to like stop the bath running, which is great. Don't ask me why we have that, it was the previous owners, but it's very much overfilled itself today and I have no idea how that's happened. Anyway, I'm gonna go in the bath, I'm gonna watch Christmas something on my laptop, and I will catch up with you when I have self-cared and repaired my muscles. What are you doing? Let's turn your podcast down. It's annoying, that little man always here when you're cooking. Who is he?
It's a comedian called Bobby Lee, and he's a funny podcaster, alright?
Right, tell us what you just did then.
I walked out into my garden, out onto my land, to my fresh herbs, herb garden.
He's being dramatic.
Basil's wee all over.
Yeah,
it,
that's true.
Where he seems to like to go for a wee. And I pulled a big bunch of rosemary out.
Is that rosemary?
Yeah, I wanted like, this is how much I wanted. But I ended up with that.
Yeah, so basically we have a herb garden that the previous owners built in, and Basil for some reason loves to wee in it.
Yeah, but he wees over there.
No,
the rosemary's there.
Oh no, no, I've seen him wee there.
Basil.
Behind the egg chair.
Basil, did you wee on this? Basil. Basil. Basil, look at me.
He's looking for basil. That's why he's weird, because we haven't got any basil in our herb garden. He's making his mark.
It doesn't magically
He's a little meerkat, look at him. He's getting mad.
He's got your wee on it. Did you do a piss on the rosemary?
Dirty boy.
Dirty pig. Oh,
oh, he got it. Anyway, I've actually just come downstairs to make myself a smoothie to rejuvenate myself, because I'm feeling really just tired and slow. I feel like a slug.
I think we brushed over the what I was trying to get at. How cool is it? I went into my own garden.
Yeah, it's very cool.
Into my own herb garden to get my own spring
weed
of rosemary.
Weed
on by my own dog.
That's named after a herb too.
Which we don't.
He's making his mark. He's saying, come on, Mum and Dad, we don't want any basil in our herb garden, so I'm going to put myself there. Anyway, I'm about to make a smoothie. So I'm using this peach and nectarine mix, which I love. Niall hates it because it's very sweet, but I love it. And then I'm going to put some milk. I'm going to put some... Do we have vanilla protein at the moment, hon?
Yeah, we're running low.
Oh, well, it's all right. I'll have a bit. We're going to have some vanilla protein when I find it. And a little bit of peanut butter. And that's it, isn't it?
This is where we should vlog from. But this is where I usually vlog from. And then this happens. What are you doing?
Just get my good angle.
I can't vlog up there. I find it really unattached from the vlog. I like vlogging down here. Right, guys, I have made my smoothie. It's terrible. I didn't make it very well, but I need something to just burst some fruit into my body. I have a knife as well. Not because I'm just a weirdo carrying around knives. Let me put that down, actually. I actually got a delivery, which I've been waiting to open with you. And it's been quite hard to hold off because I'm very excited about it. So it's very festive. And what happened was, I was on Instagram and I asked everyone if they knew of any smaller businesses that make wreaths, Christmas wreaths. And I found this one. It's so, well, it looks so nice on the website. It was on Etsy actually. Hang on, I'm so out of breath. I'm just so sleepy today, guys. I'm really sorry if I'm just gonna slack a little bit in energy. Oh my gosh, she's put flowers in there. This is so cute. So this has become my area, hasn't it? To open boxes, I just realized. I shared then that I'd ordered this wreath, and she said that basically this wreath sold out, which is so cool. And I think she messaged me saying she was gonna put something in to say thank you for supporting her. Oh, that is so nice. Oh my god, that's so cute. So her company is called Bespoke Wreath Company. Her name's Laura. Oh, that's so cute. I'll pop the link in the description box if you do want to have a look. So they had another lovely wreath that still had some left when I last looked, which was it had like figs on it, and it was really nice. But this one, Oh, it's even nicer than it looks online. It feels so like hefty. How gorgeous is that? Oh my gosh, it's bigger than I was expecting for some reason. And she hand makes them all herself. How nice is that? I'm trying at the moment, and over the Christmas period, I really want to shop through smaller businesses because obviously a lot of people have been struggling during coronavirus. Let me know if you have any suggestions of any smaller businesses for like Christmas presents and stuff and Christmas decorations, because I actually prefer like sort of handmade smaller companies because I feel like they put more love into their products and it's so clear, like this is just amazing. Let me know if you ordered one of these too. But how nice, it's got like oranges on it, cinnamon. The orange sold it to me, to be fair. Yeah, I might go put that on the door now. She's putting these lovely dried flowers. God, how nice are they, look. Oh, she's so sweet. Anyway, I'm gonna pop this on my door. I haven't decorated for Christmas yet, but I feel like our autumn wreath was just getting a bit old. The postman were probably getting tired of it. So we're gonna snazz it up and pop this one up. Hang on. Everyone we meet will smile today. It could be a mess. Oh my god! I've never had a wreath that big. Now come and see our wreath quickly. He's working, but I'm just gonna bug. Niall, can I just spare you for 1 second? He's coming. Oh my god, it's so nice. I've never had a wreath that big, you know.
Look at this, Bendy.
Look at that. Doesn't that look nice?
Oh, where's that from?
It's from that girl who's had that little company on Etsy. I ordered it, and remember she said that it lots of them sold. Oh. Remember I was telling you? It's really nice.
It's size.
So, yeah, I was going to say, because we've always got smaller ones like this. But how cute! Basil's face is like this. He reminds me so much of the squirrel from Ice Age. Aww. And he's like...
So he called you, what's his name?
Scrat.
Scrat. Scrat.
And they've actually
seen him.
No, it's Scrat.
Come on, Scratch. Scratchy.
Does anyone else think that he looks like him sometimes? It's when he like does the side eyes like that.
Basil suits him. Sir Basil.
He's not Sir Basil. Sir Basil. There was one other thing I wanted to chat to you about. Well, just give you a bit of an update on, because I don't know, I just like sharing these things. So, as you guys may know, if you saw the vlog where I was talking about how we are going to renovate, well, let me show you the state of this room. Also, the state of this area. Look at that. That's all of the giveaway stuff. By the way, thank you. I was so blown away by, I wasn't expecting like people to be so lovely about the giveaway. I was just, I knew people would probably be excited. But honestly, let me sit down on the step. It was funny because everyone was just so lovely towards me when I released the giveaway last, well, it was this week, but it'll be last week when this vlog goes up. And I actually was having like a really off moment when it went live because, you know, that situation I was telling you about that was really stressful, that lasted a long time, that I was going on about during the summer. It popped back up. So it was really nice. So everyone was just so lovely. It really lifted me up that day. But thank you guys so much. If you did enter the giveaway, I'm so excited. And once that giveaway goes live, as in like the winner on the 1st of December, I do have some other plans for over Vlogmas to do like weekly things, just to like lift the mood this time of year after, you know, I explained, you know, it's been a tough year for everyone in different ways. Yeah, everyone just seemed so happy about it, so I'm really glad. But my house is an absolute shambles at the moment because, yeah, it's all just everywhere. But anyway, going back to my story, I need my phone actually to show you, but look at this room. This room is a state, isn't it, Baz? And Basil and Bluebell, this is their playroom. This has happened this morning. Had a fight with a stick, haven't you? But yeah, this room, we are renovating. And I was really, really hoping we were gonna be able to do this for Christmas time, for when hopefully, you know, we'll be able to have our family over for like literally the first time this year. But we can't, unfortunately. It's all ready to go, but all of the work, so we're knocking through this wall, we're getting a new staircase that's gonna bend around here. I've also found a piano from somebody who's selling it. And it's the most incredible piano I have ever seen, and I'm hoping we're gonna get that before Christmas so that we can play Christmas songs on it during Christmas time, and Niall's best friend Carl can play because he's amazing. But yeah, the work isn't gonna start until the 4th of January, I think, so just really early January because of situations where we just couldn't, there was nothing we could do about it. But it's something to look forward to in the new year, and I'm really excited to get that stuff going. But we'll just have to have a bit of a shambles during Christmas time in that room for another year. Let me show you my inspo picture one more time. Sorry if you've seen this like three times, it's just very exciting. I haven't renovated anything yet in our house, so it's very exciting. So this is my inspo. I actually think it will really look like that because our room is kind of shaped really similarly, and we'll have this pillar and then the front door will be like there where we just were putting the wreath up. And where that is where our piano will be. But that's what I'm hoping it's gonna look like, and we're gonna change the floor to wooden floor, which really needs to be done because the dogs are just obsessed with that room, and Basil tore up that carpet when he was a baby. It's not quarter past 11 at night, by the way, this is a screenshot. But yeah, that will all be, we'll be doing a massive, it's something to look forward to after Vlogmas on the videos, but also just for me and my life. And if you, you know, enjoy that kind of thing, it would be like a big change. It's gonna be so weird because we're probably gonna have to live downstairs for a bit when they take the stairs out and put a brand new one in. I don't know how long that's gonna take, so it's gonna be interesting. And Poppy and Bluebell and Basil are gonna be very confused that they can't go up the stairs. But it's all ready to go, so I'm so excited to do that with you. It's just a little bit of a shame that we can't have it ready for Christmas, but you know, it's fine. Speaking of house stuff though, there is something I really want to do now. So I've actually been putting off for ages just because I hate changing beds, but I'm going to put our festive bedding on our bed and I'm very excited about it. So let me get it out. There's one new one that I've bought for the spare room, and then there is our, oh, hello. Yeah, so there's a new one that I've bought for the spare room, which is so cute. I ordered it from Next. Oh, hang on, wait a sec. Who remembers the tartan bedding that usually creeps out for Vlogmas? It's back. And then we've also got this new one. I actually love this bedding. Look, there's loads of little scenes that are quite hand-drawn looking of picking up Christmas trees. Oh, so cute, look. Presents on the car, dragging the presents. We've got a little carrying the tree. Oh, having a kiss on the tree. Oh, it's so cute, I think. It's really, really lovely. So I think I'm gonna pop that on the bedding downstairs, and I'm gonna pop that on the bedding in our room. This basically means it's Christmas in our house. Chilling by the fire as I'm trying to get your attention. Giving you a smile, I can seem to look away. I might be crazy, but I think you feel it too. Like a vibration right between us with a beautiful tune. Could we fall in love? Bedroom number one, looking very cute. I do want to add probably a festive throw and my festive kind of like statement pillows, but I'm going to do that a different day. And then we have my favourite bedroom number two. Well, master bedroom, our bedroom. Literally so cozy. I'm not sure about these pillows here. These are just from before, but I might actually, well, I definitely want to swap them out for my festive pillows again that I haven't got yet. Although, this is the first year we've had the pink wall at Christmas time, and it kind of clashes. This is the first time I've actually looked at it from this angle. These pillows definitely aren't doing it for me right now. It'll look much better, trust me, but it's just the coziest bedding. And you know what? It's 2:30 and it literally looks like 7 p.m. at night, so the curtains are getting closed ready for tonight. Okay, I've been practicing the John Lewis Christmas advert song, and I'm gonna have a go, just at a tiny section, just because I don't know, I just love the song. I feel like I can't do it justice because her voice is just incredible. But I'm just gonna do my version. Put it in your pocket, watch it move a mountain of all the things to be. I choose the kindness, and if you gave some to me, I think we'd find ourselves here dancing in the street. Everyone we meet would smile a little daydream. It could be amazing. Wouldn't it be wonderful if everybody gave a little love? Good evening, everybody. I'm currently in my bathroom and it's been quite a long time since I saw you. Do you know what? That song that I sang on the keyboard has been like overly stuck in my head. Like, not in a nice way. Like, I love that song, but every time I just do something, I'm subconsciously singing it and my throat actually hurts now. Do any of you do that? It's like way past stuck in my head. It's like glued to my brain. Very irritating. Just literally, I would just pick up my phone and start singing, "Everybody gave a little love." Very annoying. Anyway, I actually came into my bathroom to do something with you, and it's very exciting actually because I am partnering up with, is it Allure or Eyelure? I say Eyelure, but I think it is technically Allure. So this is the eyebrow tint that I use. You will have seen me use it and walk around looking like Niall when it's developing quite often. Very excitedly, they wanted to work with me, which I thought was so cool because obviously it's just something that I use all the time. And also they do the stick-on eyelashes, which are my favorite ones. If I ever, literally since I was like 14, when did I start wearing fake eyelashes? I don't know. But whenever I used to go out on a night out, and now I don't have my extensions, they're the ones that I use. They're just the best. But I'm partnering up with them because they basically are gonna do a Black Friday deal of some sort. I don't know the exact deal, but they're gonna do a deal. This Friday coming for you when this vlog is up is Black Friday. So I will pop I expect I'll have a link which I'll pop in the description box. But if you've never tried these guys, they're so good. So this is the eyebrow tint, Dyebrow. And as you can see, this one lasts up to 6 weeks. It only takes 15 minutes to do, and obviously it's just so much cheaper than going to a salon. And this pack can do up to 12 applications, which is obviously great because this pack is not expensive. I'm gonna do it with you today. So first of all, I need to take off my makeup around my eyebrows. It is essential before you use this pack to do a spot test. Is that what you call it? No, that's for hair. Patch test, that's the one, to make sure that you're not allergic to it. And some people also do, when they do this, put like jelly, petroleum, I can't remember what it's called, but you know, like the jelly to make like a barrier so that you don't get it on your skin at all. But I don't do that either because I'm lazy. And to be fair, I'm not too bad at applying this, and I'm usually all right. All you have to do with this pack, is so easy as well, is you have these two products. Oh, so we have the color cream and we have the activator. So all you're gonna do is pop a little bit, hang on, and they've got loads of different colors of this. I've got the dark brown. We just put a little blob of the color cream in there, and then I'm going to pop 5 drops of the applicator in with that in the little mixy bowl. So had a bit of a fit then. I think that was 5, wasn't it? So I'm gonna mix that together now, and that basically is my solution that I'm gonna be popping on. I'm not sure how long I'm gonna put it on today. I sometimes leave it on longer if I want a darker brow, but mine aren't too bad at the moment because I didn't do them that long ago, but they could do with being a tiny bit darker. So I will probably do them for like 7 minutes, but it's between 5 and 10 minutes usually that you'd do it. Once you've mixed it all together, we've got our little wand, which also comes in the pack. I do kind of need a mirror for this because I don't really want to get it on my skin. But we're going to just literally use this brush to pop it on. You want to try and obviously avoid your skin. That's why having the jelly can help just create that barrier to be safe. Sorry guys, I'm literally half asleep. I'm so tired today. My energy is a little bit low at the moment. But me and Al are gonna go and make some fajitas in a minute, which I'm very, well not in a minute, he's in the gym at the moment. When he gets out of the gym, we're gonna make some fajitas for dinner. And we're gonna catch up with the undoing. I'm so excited to catch up and find out what happens. If you're watching it, who the heck do you think is the one that killed her? Because I can't work it out. It reminds me of a book I've read. It is a book actually, isn't it? That's where it's come from. Okay, I'm gonna leave this on now for 7 minutes and then I will catch up with you and give it a clean off and show you what it looks like after, but see you in 7.
If this isn't what happiness looks like, then I don't know what is. Does anyone ever wish they were their dog? Because I do. Anyway, I've just wiped off the excess on my eyebrows, so this is how we're looking. I'm not gonna lie to you, I forgot to set my timer, so they are a lot darker than I was expecting, because they were on a little bit longer than I was planning on, but I don't really mind that, I quite like a dark brow. But if you do want to try the dye brow, I will leave a link to the Black Friday sale in the description box, but as you can see, they just make them look so much fuller and thicker. Anyway, I'm actually gonna head downstairs. There was one thing though that I did want to show you because these are so good and I recently discovered them. They taste as good as you think they'll taste. So basically, I saw these when I was checking out at the supermarket the other day. These are chocolate digestive gingerbread biscuits. I even saw chocolate pudding today, but I went for these ones again. They are so flipping good. I just got them in Co-op. Posted these on my story and loads of you were like, where the heck did you find them? Literally just in a tiny little Co-op near me. But if you guys haven't tried these, and for any Americans who don't actually have digestives, this is what a digestive looks like. And I don't know why they're called a digestive, but it's just a biscuit and they are just insane. Here he is.
Pizza
time. I don't know what you're gonna say then. Here he is. You just like body pumped me. Like that, oosh, at each other. Right, we're gonna have some fajitas for dinner. So I thought we'd do it together. Although it's very, very easy. We're just using, oh, we've got extra mild, super tasty today. Not a bit of you.
Extra mild.
It's a bit of me. I love a bit of extra mild.
No, that's how I'd describe you, extra mild.
No, this one has. This one's got the really nice sauce in it. It's got like a powder that you make into a sauce. Do you remember? It tastes like the blue Doritos. Do you remember?
Just
have a look. I can't open it, I'm just scaring it. It's this little onion. I think it is anyway. Yeah, it is. Smell that.
Do you cook it in it or do you put it on at the end?
I think you put it on the end. You cook it in this one, the salsa sauce. Actually,
no. No, that's a topping.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is for sure.
It's like cooking sauce, hun.
I thought that's normal.
Oh, chef, I don't even know what you're doing with a fajita. Anyway, basically.
Usually you get salsa in these things.
Yeah, I know, but this was different. That's what I was saying. This is the sauce for this one.
Embarrass me on YouTube.
So we're gonna fry some chicken, pepper, onion in the cooking sauce and then make fajitas basically. Simple as that. Lovely jubbly. This is a really good meal though to have when you're in a rush. What are you doing, hun?
These, I got sent these and it's a charity IPA. And all their profits go to towards child poverty, helping child poverty.
Does it?
So I thought I'd...
What are they called?
Try them out.
The Bread Brewery.
The Bread Brewed Project.
Oh. Support them. Good go on, course. Then. I don't like IPA, but I'll watch. Closer from across the room. My heart is pounding really fast. I don't know what to do. Could we find love in this winter wonderland? Yummy dinner.
Just burp.
He just burped. No, this flipping man's talking again. He's talking this way. He's talking again. Now to turn it off.
It's a different guy.
Oh, stop listening.
One's American and one has got a.
I'm not paying attention. He's got annoying voices and they talk and talk. Anyway, here's our dinner.
I always love having fajitas because it looks so appetizing, all spread out.
Yeah, I thought it looked quite cool with the pan on the board.
Looks lovely, Niall. So, we're going to eat this, and actually, we need to catch up on the undoing hun. We need to find out. I don't know, should we?
Oh, well. You can watch it now, and then I'll play after.
But then I'm a celeb's on in 20 minutes. This is the thing.
This is the thing. I'm a celeb.
This time of year, there's just too much on TV.
It's actually quite cool.
Yeah, no, actually, during winter, I was thinking earlier, I just look forward to so much the end of the day, sitting on the sofa, watching Strictly Come Dancing, or I'm a Celebrity, or The Undoing, or The Great British. There's so many good shows on. In the summer, there isn't, but in the winter. Oh my God, look at my eyebrows, it's got all wonky. Anyway, we're going to watch one of them and eat our fajitas. What are we going to watch? I want to watch I'm a Celeb. We'll watch The Undoing later in bed. Right, I'm just actually about to head up to bed to get snuggly and have a go on a new Nintendo game. I'm just about to make my favourite chocolate milkshake. I rediscovered this recently. I used to drink this all the time when I was younger. Do you know what? I used to actually drink a pint of this every night with a packet of salt and vinegar crisps and a Rocky. That was like my routine. But I found this again and it's just the best. I'm gonna pop a couple of scoops in. And the thing about this that just like amazes me is it looks like, you know, hot chocolate, if you just put the powder in with milk, it just goes all clumpy. This one doesn't. It's so, just baffles me. Hang on. Right, I'm just gonna pop the milk in. Now watch this. You think, oh, it's not gonna blend, but it does, right there. I might have to add some more chocolate, to be honest. So freaking good. Right, we're gonna go upstairs with our Nesquik milkshake. You come in. We're gonna go to bed. You know what that means, don't you? We're gonna go to bed. Come on in. And we're gonna snuggle into our fresh bedding. Isn't that just the best feeling in the world? Literally the best feeling, isn't it, Baz? Do you wanna come and join me? Come on in. Oh, do you like the new bedding? It's a bit snuggly, isn't it? Anyway, I actually am going to love you and leave you. I'm about to play a little game of, hang on, it's a new game that I got on my Nintendo. I feel like such a nerd saying that, but I just love the Nintendo. It's called Cooking Tycoon. It's a bit like, did you ever play Dyna Dash? It's that kind of vibe. It's very intense, but weirdly, I've been playing it when I get into bed recently, because you have to be so focused to do the game. It just switches off my mind so well, because you know I was saying, if you watch my recent vlogs, that I've been struggling sleeping with just sort of being wired before I go to bed and thinking about everything I need to do the next day. But since I've been playing this, I've actually been fine, because I've been so focused and it tires out my brain so much because you're that focused, and then I just fall asleep straight after. I love it. Anyway, I'm gonna love you and leave you. I hope you enjoyed this vlog. I will hopefully see you in my next video, which will be the last vlog before Vlogmas. I can't believe that. That's so crazy. The next vlog's gonna be a bit emotional, so yeah, I might be quite emotional in the next vlog, and you'll see why in the next vlog. Not in a good way. Anyway, I'm gonna love you and leave you. I hope you're all feeling okay. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I will hopefully see you in the next one. See you soon.